We think that the UN Secretary General's panel on digital cooperation is a unique opportunity that a number of people from different regions with different backgrounds can get together. And in our view, the value added that this panel can create is precisely to look into, not into the substance of cooperation, but look into mechanisms and modalities and principles of cooperation in order to foster a cooperation that helps everybody in the world to benefit from opportunities. So in our view, the key principles are things like inclusiveness, transparency. Everybody should be involved who is interested in cooperation. It should also be based on a consensus-oriented decision-making, not that a majority can overrule a minority or can ignore the needs of people somewhere else in the world. So consensus orientation is a key issue for us. Another key issue for us is that not too much of the governance or the cooperation is centralized, because the world is still different depending on where you live, in a rural area, in an urban area, on the south, in the north. So we need some flexibility, some diversity also, like we have in our real lives, also in the governance models and in the cooperation, so that different needs can be responded to with different solutions. But they should be interoperable, they should work hand in hand, so that a decision somewhere doesn't have negative effects on people that live elsewhere. So we really need new mechanisms, better mechanisms for cooperation, and we hope the panel can contribute to this. The more solution-oriented this cooperation is, the more problems are solved or opportunities are put forward in a way that the maximum of people can benefit from it, the more this cooperation will thrive and will be respected, or be more people will work together. So we really should maybe be less ideological in what we do in terms of what's the role of the UN or of governments, but we should more be some more substantive solution oriented on particular issues, find out what are the key actors in a particular field of action, get them together, make them work together transparently, inclusively, and consensus oriented. We think that the UN Declaration on Human Rights is a fundamental document that should remain the basis of our actions, of our activities, and also of the protection that everybody in the world should benefit from. But we need to translate it. I wouldn't say it needs to be updated, but it needs to be translated in terms of what this means in the digital world. There are some institutions that have already done some work in this regard. For instance, the Council of Europe has issued a Internet User's Guide on Human Rights to tell a user what do your human rights mean in the internet, how can you enforce them, what are potential remedies if they are not respected. And so we need to do more in translating the human rights in the internet and digital era, but we don't necessarily have to amend the rights.